All right, welcome back, baseball fans. This is an eliminating the Ohio players analysis. Ohio players expansion team in the American League North. Had the first pick in the draft a year ago. Made a big deal with Oakland to land Vita Blue. Didn't really work out. Vita Blue went 3-5 in 82 innings. 4.57 ERA, 1.45 WHIP. Nothing really. Only one complete game. Just, you know, bad year for a pitcher and the ace of your staff, and everything falls from there. The team was actually just one game lower, half game behind where they were last year, but a higher winning percentage because they played more games, showed to be more competitive, lowered the team ERA by 4/5 of a run from 4.38 to 3.59. Batting average about the same. Interesting team. Gene Kline's at 328 with a 334 card. There's some nice bats in this team that some did okay. Dreesen 315, Cepeda 287. But at the bottom there, George Hendrick, I don't understand it. It's a 280 card, it's 198. Bill Robinson, 290 card, it's 228. That'll just kill any team. You don't have to be an expansion team. It's the rare blend of sloth and weakness to... to underachieve as an underdog. They did sign Larry Demery, looking at the pitching, and he was untouched. Look at that, zero ERA, good for him. Tom Hall, 1-4 closer. See, that's gonna kill you. I mean, Vita Blue and Tom Hall, your ace and your closer are 4-9, so that's gonna short circuit your season. Rudy May went to the All-Star game because his ERA was so low, but he was 1-6 because he lost a couple more games after the All-Star game. Oh boy. Doc Ellis went to the All-Star game a year ago. This year he was still good. Wayne Simpson is past his prime. And not a whole lot else to add, really. Let's take a look at the Ohio players. The dozen guys are coming back, and I think it looks pretty good, folks. You tell me if I'm wrong here, but we got some nice hitters and players here. Orlando Cepeda won the award they made for the designated hitter in 1973. He was the best, though he had competition from Ron Bloomberg, Antonio Oliva, all those National League hitters as well. Cepeda would move to the American League and take advantage of the DH rule. Great year. Now, Elroy Hendricks, the left-handed, this is what we typically find for expansion teams, guys who don't play much, 159 at-bats, but he's what every team wants, a left-handed hitting catcher with power, until you find one, and then you're wondering, well, maybe I didn't really need a left-handed hitting catcher with power, but he can also play first base, and he hit 2 or 3 home runs this year. He hit 261 with 5 home runs. He led the club in home runs. Matter of fact, George Hendrick and Bill Robinson combined to hit 3 in 256 plate appearances. And Elrod had 5 in 69. So it's just how lucky you get in a short sample. He'll platoon with Ike Brown. Great on base machine is Ike. Very versatile is Ike. Then you got Dreesen's card with the Reds. Excellent card with him. 301 hitter. Dave Cash. His cards get even better. Oh, he's 300. He'll hit 305, I think. Larry Lentz, a speedy middle infielder. He can take over for short. You know, needs some help defensively. Here's Bill Robinson. He played in right field all year. Wow. That's a wild card. I mean, that's 25 homers and a 288 average and great defense. And it just didn't work out. George Hendrick actually played center. He's a 2 in center. And that's a decent card, too. 280, 279, 19 dingers. Yeah, those cards could be better. I get it. But and then you have the 4 pitchers. Vita Blue just did not live up to it. He's a starter 8, and he won 22 games for Oakland in 75. So Oakland was fading in 75. I mean, I guess they still won the American League West, but 22 wins, 301 ERA. This guy, Lynn McLaughlin, his best year starting was a Cardinal. 270. And then we got Jesse Jefferson. Not so much for him. He's okay. 411. And Demiri, I had a scoreless performance this year. Righty gets righties out. Nice. Back end pitcher. Lefties, he's okay. He's okay over there. You can make him a starter if you want, but they got plenty of starting options. Man, it's about time. Maybe next year will be the year where Ohio gets the 500, possibly a wild card. The potential's there. They just had the other eight guys who from our 72, most of them, they're not going to miss. Speaking of those eight guys, let's take a look at the eight other players from 72 and see who we're going to keep, who we're going to waive, and who we're going to retire. All right, baseball fans, here's the first player to review. It's Gene Kleins. Had a fantastic year in 1972, the best year of his career. 334. Well, if you exclude a 405 year and 37 at bats in 70, that would have been a fun looking Strat card. Got on the MVP list in 72 with that. He's got a nice year in 76 and 77. I mean, he's all around. He's a small, speedy leadoff hitter type. And Pittsburgh, the Mets, Texas, the Cubs, they'd all try him out throughout the decade. Yeah, he's a player. I think he's a keeper. Again, these expansion teams need all the help they can get. There's no reason you'd want to cut this guy or retire him or anything like that. So, good start. We're going to go right over to their sheet next to Gene Kleins and make him $10,000. Come on back. Next player is Jackie Hernandez. This guy came into the league in 69. Now, he would be part of that expansion bubble. 65. Played a little bit before the expansion bubble of 69. But really, look at the plate appearances. In 1969, the Kansas City Royals. So they probably took him out of California, Minnesota. They didn't really want him. He didn't really do much. He's probably somewhere between AAA and the majors, a quadruple A player. So he had a full season for Kansas City in 69. He never really hit above 231. We use this card, a 188 card, just to play third base against lefties. Actually, in 73, I think they make his card with Pittsburgh. Let's go check it out by looking at the roster sheet. The Pirates, did they make a Jackie Hernandez card? We'll go down to Pittsburgh here. Infielders. Be an extra player. And they did. So, let's be optimistic and assume that that card is good enough to platoon with. I mean, it's always good to start optimistic and want to keep a guy, and then after further review, put him on waivers. So let's start it that way with Jackie Hernandez. Put some light at the end of the tunnel for this young team. Jerry Kenney. He had some nice seasons as a versatile player for the Yankees. Another expansion opportunity for Jerry. So he only had 74 at-bats, then boom. The Yankees needed a full-time third baseman, and he got the job in 69 at age 24. He could also play center field, interesting, and third base pretty decently as well. Had some speed, not too much power. 70 had some decent power, but the average was down. The 71 card was decent. We used the 72 card, and now the 73 card doesn't exist because it's only 19 plate appearances. They're not going to print that one. I'm not even going to check that one. So we're going to retire a Jerry Kenney. First retirement. Yeah, it was coming. Writing on the wall, would you like to say. And the last guy is probably the guy with the most longevity. That's Daryl Thomas. And speaking of utility, he is the perfect utility player that a young team like this could use. So he did his big deal with the Dodgers. I think he might have gotten a World Series appearance. In 81, he was on that team that won the World Series, and he was He was back with the Padres in 77, 78. Went to the Padres, went to the Dodgers in 79. But we use this card as a 230 hitter. He's right around a lot of blah, but he's got a nice OPS in 75 at least, 728. 381 slugging, 347 on base. 611 plate appearances, the most he would have in the 75 card. 28 stolen bases. Yeah, so that's probably, and he moves from the Padres to the Giants, and then eventually back to the Padres. That card's certainly worthwhile, particularly when you know this team needs players all over the diamond, and that's where Daryl Thomas makes his living. All right, now the pitching. Oh, we got some, another sort of the Daryl Thomas of pitching. Rudy May, another versatile guy. Guy who could pitch in the rotation and in the bullpen very effectively. Also a left-handed pitcher, good at getting right-handed batters out. Had a nice long career. Again, lots of teams make him an expansion player. Nobody will miss him too much. It's not like, you know, Babe Ruth, or I guess you should say, it's not like Hank Aaron or Johnny Bench, where you know you've got to place those players on specific teams. Yeah, he could put him anywhere, so why not an expansion team? So, yeah, he's got some nice years coming up. 73, his ERA is a little high. 74, 75, and 76 are available, and they look good for the Yankees. 76, he's with Baltimore for most of it. So that's another keeper, and already we're at four. This is outstanding. Well, I mean, it's good that they have four keepers. Now we got Doc Ellis. I'm not even going to look. I'm just going to make him a keeper. We know we're keeping Doc Ellis. Now we can see, remember the guy we saw before, Jackie Hernandez? Now he goes to waivers. See how that works? Most likely. Let's take a look at Doc Ellis. There should be plenty of years to choose from for Doc. I think the 76 year, was that the year with the Yankees where he won 19 games? 17 games? Yeah, that's the year. Yeah, that year, that's on the table. And he pitches on 3 days rest. Go get it. Instead of doing it for the Yankees, do it for the Iowa players. Go get that card. Actually, he's got a good card in 74, the Pirates, but he can't pitch on 3 days rest. If that's what you need. You may not need that because you already have Vita Blue, Lynn McLaughlin doing that sort of thing. Good problem to have. See what I mean? There's lots of potential here. If they just can find the rest, just complete a roster, have reasonable defense. I mean, the ERA, they lowered their ERA from 4.3 to 3.5, which is really good. Wayne Simpson had a really bad injury in 70 as a promising rookie, 21 years old. Finished fourth in Rookie of the Year. He was 14-3, 3.02 ERA. And then he made a comeback, but it really wasn't that good. And now in 73, yeah, we could give him the courtesy of waivers if Kansas City has the card. So let's take a look. Kansas City Royals, do you have Wayne Simpson here? And I don't see him there. I don't remember him that late. No, they don't have a 73 Wayne Simpson. Not listed there, 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 or there. And not there. Not listed as the extra players either. So no Simpson. We'll have to retire him. The last guy is Tom Hall. Boy, you would think the Reds would have really missed him, and I'm sure they do, because Tom Hall had an incredible 1972 for a World Series team, the Big Red Machine. He had good years with the Twins and the Reds. There's Tom. Nice lefty. 6 foot 150. Boy, the guy was a leaf, a feather. 10-1, 261 ERA for your Big Red Machine and 124 innings, 107 whip. Relief 4, starter 7. What? Man. So, again, all your dynasty teams or your all-star World Series teams, they can't keep all their players and they get pillaged. And Ohio took away Tom Hall after a distinguished career in Minnesota prior to that. So then 73, 4, 5, and 6, he's okay. Actually, 73, he's got a 117 whip in 103 innings with the Reds. Let's make sure they have that card after losing out on the Wayne Simpson card. There it is, Tom Hogsis. Okay, that's a keeper. So now they can make trades. They have six guys they want to keep, but oddly enough, they'll trade out of some of these guys. It's a good problem to have, particularly when you're as bad as the Ohio players are. So, potential exists. You've got two starting pitchers. All you need is two more. Make sure you keep it strong in the bullpen with Demary and maybe Tom Hall again. Find a bat here to replace Jerry Kenny and Jackie Hernandez at third base. A strong third baseman would help this team a whole lot. A really good third baseman would be pretty bananas for the Ohio players as we do their analysis. Thanks for checking out the analysis elimination videos, and we'll see you next time.